Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how you can easily use terms like and, or, and not when searching in the Finder. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now on the Finder, let's say you want to do a search for JPEG files that have the word test in them. Now I can click on the search button here at the top right or use Command F and then search for test. And then I have the choices name contains test or content contains test. I could select name contains test and I get results that have test somewhere in the name. Now instead I could have just typed name colon and then test with no space there and then a return and it gets me the same thing. Anything with that phrase in the name. Now let's say I wanted to narrow this down to only be JPEG files. And I could see a few of them here. Here's one, here's another one. Notice it's a different extension for this one with an E in the extension. And so I want to keep that in mind when I'm searching. Now the straightforward way to do this is to click the plus button next to save here in the search line in the window. And then I can go and select something else like name matches and put .jpg. And then I get file names that match this. But I'm missing the JPEG. If I change it to that, I get those, but now I'm missing the other kind too. Plus, this is kind of convoluted. You're doing the first part of the search up here in the search box, and then you're adding additional criteria in different lines here. I can continue to add more things here, like I can say name matches and then .jpg. And now I could say I get nothing because there are no files that meet all three conditions, having test, having .jpeg in the title, and .jpg in the title. So how would I do this? Well, it gets even more convoluted than that because what I would do is I would remove this one. I'd hold the Option key down and the plus changes to three dots. Click on that and then I would remove this one here and then say any of the following are true, which is equivalent to or, and say name matches dot and then JPG and then another one and name matches dot JPEG. And now I finally get the results I want, matching everything. But you can see how convoluted this was to do. There's an easier way. If we just go back to the search box here, we can do it all by typing. Now if I were to type name colon test, then I get everything with test in it. And you'd think that if I would type and name colon dot JPG that I would get things that match both of those, but I don't. The reason is because you can't just use and, you have to use and all uppercase, A-N-D with capital letters. Then the search box will recognize that as the Boolean operator that it is and you get things that match both of those. Now I could do or as well, so I can do name colon dot JPEG, but I get really weird results now because I get things that don't have test in them. So what this is actually doing is it's saying anything with the name test and JPG in there or anything that has JPEG in there, which you can see I get some of the results there. So you can use parentheses in here to make it clearer what you want. So I'll put one after this and one after that. And now that's my complete Boolean structure there to search for everything with the name test and either of these two spellings of the JPEG extension. And you can see how much more straightforward this is to having to do that by building it in the Finder by adding different lines of search criteria. The key to remember here is using capital letters for and capital letters for or. And I could do the same thing here with not. So for instance, if I were to change and to not, then my results would be everything with test in the name, but not including anything with JPG or JPEG in the title. And you can see that's what I get here. And you could use parentheses to make this as complex as you want, all on one line. And if you want to save them, you could save it as a save search, also known as a smart folder. You could simply copy and paste this as a piece of text somewhere to reuse at a later time so you don't have to type it all. Oh, by the way, you could also search for things like kind and then put a standard term like image there and it'll give you all the images. And you could do date as well, but you don't want to put date. You want to put created or modified and then colon and then format your date like this. And then you'll get results. If you want things that are from before that date, put a less than in front of it. If you want things that are after that date, you put a greater than in front of it. And then, of course, you can use and then put another date there to get a range. So I hope you found this tip useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.